So once you've overlocked and finished off all the seams, the hem trim needs to be added back on and overlocked. It's a very, very simple stitching. Simba, go there. Go and find Simba. Go and find Simba. Simba.
Come on,
Simba. Just a straight seam, both fabrics facing each other, and then we're just going to lock it, overlock it. This is quite a simple and easy procedure, but problem that you have generally when these seams need overlocking and the border is attached, you can't actually get right to the end, and it's those ending bits that start to, ouch, are you hitting daddy? The end bits where the fabrics meet up, then you can't get access to that. So that's one of the reasons why I like to unattach. Suleiman, you're poking me, Butul. Naughty. Naughty Suleiman. Is it naughty Suleiman? Are you naughty? Suleiman, are you naughty? It should be a standard practice that, you know, they should overlook these, but sadly. Yeah. What are you doing? Say, Mary. Naughty boy. Naughty boy. Why are you? Are you a naughty boy? You want to go upstairs? You want to go upstairs? Are you going upstairs? So we'll leave that to overlock a little bit later on. So I'm going to do the shoulder seams, and I'll do this invisibly. So both the, I've not attached the lining to this, but I'm going to attach the, first of all, I'm going to attach the front part of the gummies. So this has a lining already attached to it. Suleiman! No, don't move that. Don't. Ganda bacha. Sorry about this. So we're going to attach this in two goes. First of all, we're going to do the, this just makes it a little bit easier to handle the fabrics. So we'll do the one first, and then will attach. And I normally I prefer to do this on like an invisible seam. So what happens with the invisible seam is you place the lining on top of this, and when you turn it over, this portion of the seaming is actually hidden away inside of the double seaming.
I just see the.
Are you gonna go outside? Okay, let's open the door for you. So by placing the lining on top of this, I'm just closing off the shoulder seam. So there's actually four pieces of fabric at the moment that are being attached. And before turning this over, I'm just going to trim away the excess. I as the fabrics are fine and a little bit of this line will be visible on top of the shoulder. So on the top of the shoulder you should have a clear seam like this, which stops actually the threads from coming out. So now I'm just gonna attach the Oh no, where is Mel? Where is Mel? So that's just a seam to hold the two fabrics together and trim away. There's a bit of an imbalance, so we've trimmed before trimming away the excess. I've just seamed that just to keep those fabrics in place, and a bias cut piece of fabric to actually finish the neckline off. Baz, come on, Zippa. Zippa's not outside. Yes, Zippa. Zippa's not outside. Do you want to call Fluff? Is Fluff outside? Call Fluff. Yes, Zippa. Call Fluff. Come on, Fluff.
Call Fluff.
So this bias strip, I'm going to place it on, leave a little bit, like a quarter of an inch prior to starting stitching. That's for the turning towards the inside. Yeah, but what is it?
Dish.
Oh, what is it?
Dish.
Dish. What is that? Now that quarter of an inch that we left initially, what I'm doing is turning that, slightly just turning that so that that will go on the inside, and then on the other side as well, when we get to the end, just turn it over, tuck it in. Is it Mel there? Have you seen a Mel? Have you seen a Mel there? Close hard, that's it, good boy.